People tell me, Brother Zakir, you travel throughout the world. Don't you have problems? Alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. Allah's help. I know many of my colleagues who keep on traveling, they have had several problems. And my appearance, the beard, the cap, and a coat, though I look like a joker, it's a soft target. But with God's grace, with Allah's grace, alhamdulillah, I never had problems. I spent time, many a times, with these immigrations and police officers. I was there in New York 2 days before 9/11. I just left New York. I was there for 2 weeks. Alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. Good I left. If I'd been there during 9/11, maybe I would be implicated, possibly. I went to London immediately. And last time I was in USA, though I've been invited several times because of my tight schedule, I was in 2003. I'd gone to Los Angeles to receive an award. Immediately, I was prepared that during immigration, I'll be interrogated, the way I look. I'm mentally prepared. They asked me, why have you come here? I said, to receive an award. Award for what? Do you belong to a charitable organization? What award are you getting? I said, to serve humanity. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, speak ye the truth and the truth shall free you. I speak the truth. That's why I've got the award. And it went on, the long conversation. Later on, I went to the customs, and I purposely say, I've come for an Islamic conference. Islamic conference, go for checking. They opened my bag, and they see my video cassette, Terrorism and Jihad. And on that cover, there is a pistol. So the customs officer says, that do you believe in jihad? I said, yes, I believe in jihad. Even Jesus Christ believed in jihad, in striving and struggling. No, I mean, do you believe in fighting? I said, you read your Bible. If you read the Bible speaks about fighting. If you read the book of Numbers, chapter number 31, verse number 1 to 19, the book of Exodus, chapter number 22, verse number 18 to 20, the book of Exodus, chapter number 32, verse number 27 to 28, and Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, said, in the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 22, verse number 36, that take ye the sword and go and fight. So immediately, most of the custom officers, 8 or 10, gathered together, and they started asking, sir, can we ask you one more question? So I just told my host on the mobile that, please don't worry, I'm stuck up here, I'm just doing dawah. I keep on traveling, mashallah. I've been to Australia, to UK several times. By God's grace, time I did spend, not more than a couple of hours. I know many of my colleagues were detained. Many of my colleagues, means my speakers, I'm not talking about my Bombay speakers, I'm talking about the international speakers who keep on traveling. They have been detained, they have been deported. Allah's grace that so far, I have not been detained, I haven't been deported. Maximum half an hour in our dawah, and I see to it that whenever I get opportunity, I grab it. But I see to it that I quote the scriptures. I follow the guidance of the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, which says, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ قَلْمِتِنْ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Come to common terms as between us and you. So when we come to common terms, most of the problems are solved. This talk, what we're having today, was supposed to be held more than a month back. I was supposed to be in London. That's why this talk is delayed. And when I landed on the 10th of August on Heathrow Airport, and I receive a call from my wife. Zakir, where are you? I said, why? No, why are you in the airport outside? What happened? I said, no, we just received information that there are some 21 Muslims arrested who are supposed to do bomb blasts, etc., etc. But alhamdulillah, I had my own camera crew with me. We were 12 of us. All of them, cap, beard, God's grace, we passed through very well. I had my talk in Birmingham. It was successful. Next day, sometimes we go and do shooting. So next day, we went to one of the Jewish graveyards and we were shooting. Shooting, not shooting, we were recording. You know, we in our lingo, we say shooting means recording on the video camera. Just to get stock shot of the city. And we spent a couple of hours in the Jewish graveyard. Later on, we went to one of the churches, did the recording shooting. Then we went for breakfast and we came back to the hotel in the afternoon. Then we get information. The police of Birmingham, they're trying to track us down. Maybe some passerby went and complained. They were looking for 7 or 8 terrorists with cap and beard. Who are these people? They had the number plate, and they knew it was a green car. So what they did, they phoned the insurance company, and they tried to find out where we were, and finally they located us in the hotel. But luckily, while doing inquiry, they even happened to speak with the person who I had breakfast with, and he happened to be a very famous politician, Muslim politician. So when the chief of that area, of the police station, spoke to him, that, you know, we're looking for these terrorists. He said, what nonsense are you talking? Do you know 2 months back, I had given a DVD of a person by the name of Dr. Zakir Naik. He said, yes, he's the same person. Oh, same person. Problem solved. The passerbys who had reported, you know, beard is dangerous. Beard, cap, dangerous. You have to be careful. But again, God's help, Allah's help, and I'm safely back here. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been here to give the talk. We Muslims should not be afraid. We should speak the truth, but with hikmah. You have to be careful. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 125, Udu ila sabili rabbika bil hikmah wal mu'azatil hasna wajadilum billati ahsan. Invite all to the way of thy Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them and reason with them in the ways that are best and most gracious. When we speak, you have to speak with hikmah.